from Jon Gibson and Cruise Control, local group. Glad to have you.
Praise God tonight. How's everybody doing? It's a little hot, the vocals up here. How's everybody doing? Beautiful day in Tucson, huh? And a nice dry heat. I respect it though. But it is nice and dry. Anybody ever been to New York City in the summertime?
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to continue with praise, but something you guys know, you can sing along. All your vocal riffs and all that kind of stuff. How many of you have a different version of Lord, I Lift Your Name on High? Everybody's got their own version.
That's how it goes with anointed songs, you know, they just keep going. And they're great right that way, right? Everyone has his use.
Amen. Amazing Grace.
Lord, Thank you. Chains and fire, Lord, just let that
let them not break you, Lord, that they may have peace in their heart, Lord. Invite you into their lives. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Amen. To be free.
escaping. You know, my father's struggling with cancer right now. I'm going to leave a year, a month to live or something like that. 3 years ago, I'm still here. He's the same. Father's crazy, man. He's the same. He came to the Lord after having a cocaine freebase heart attack, you know what I mean? At 40. You know? And then he just said, okay, dude. You got me. And he brought the whole family to Christ, all of us. That was, I use that terminology because there's a pastor. He's not a pastor, he's an evangelist. His name is Brother Manuel Carrizales, and he's in Bakersfield. And Manny was a hardcore, he's a hardcore bato, you know, from Bakersfield. Yeah, man. Clean, though. When you see Manny, he's smooth, man. He's, you know. Oh, man, his hair is so perfect, you know. And boy, he went through stuff, though. He is a wonderful brother, man. He's actually got a trach in his throat because when they pulled out the catheter when he OD'd on heroin, they forgot to deflate it, ripped his esophagus. So now he's got the miracle is he can talk and preach. He can never tell. He just buttons everything all the way up here. He's a bato anyway, so you know. Good people, you know, he's just like amazing, you know. He's a great guy. What a brother, man. Awesome. We do a lot of ministry with him. Now I forgot what I was going to say about him, but boy, he is a great. Oh, yeah, that's why he's the dude, because he was out there one day, and he was at the end of his rope, you know. He had nothing left, and there's this place where all the buckles go, you know, when they're down and out and everything, just at the end of their rope. It's just a dusty place in Bakersfield. They go out there to smoke, drink, and just whatever. But he went out there to talk with God, and it's a dusty place, and just everything's blowing around. And the wind was blowing, tumbleweeds blowing. But somebody had carved Jesus' name into the dirt. I mean, you've heard that terminology before, but this is what happened to Manny. Somebody had carved his name into the mud, and it dried. And so the wind was blowing. Everything was blowing away except the name Jesus. And Jesus said to Manny, look, everything in your life is gone. Everything's blown away with the wind, even you. But I'm here. You know? And Manny said, okay, dude. And that was it. He's been serving God ever since, and he became an advocate for young people. He's done amazing ministry out there. Pray for him, Brother Manny Carrizales. He is awesome. Another thing, I got a reminder. There's a person that I owe a CD collection to because I couldn't find their address. God forgive me, but it's the only CD collection that, well, anyway, it's an MP3 collection thing, and it's, you might know them. Their names are Willie and Rosie Perales. You know them? Did they get it? Is that you? I got your thing. Good. I could not get your address for the life of me, and I so apologize, but I got a picture and a CD, and I did everything that I ever got. God bless you. Remember when you used to say that? Okay, Sarah, Sarah, remember that thing? Alright. ready to move, you know? It really is. Wants us to get excited about Jesus, man, you know? We should be that way, really. I can't sleep. I get all hyped on Jesus now. Some fucking king or something. We need to be like that. We need to be excited about Jesus.
Thank you. went the wrong way home one day, and God just planted that vision in my heart. And I really prayed for a long time, over a year, about it, and just asking God, what is it that you want me to do? What is it that you want me to do? And I'm praying. I know you don't just want me to pray. What else is it? What do you want me to do? And so he led me to a location and gave me a vision to begin this ministry we call the Underground. The reason it's called the Underground is because it's the church to the underground culture. And we want to bring, we want to go down underground with them and then bring them to marvelous life. Yes,
might have been, oh,
saw the bad woman and soon be my chimney. And what do you keep that voice you hear while someone's praying for your cheek? Oh, while someone's praying for your
Thank you.
really good to have you guys here tonight. I guess, again, thanks, and we'll keep you posted on the underground. Keep John in prayer, brothers in prayer, Cruise Control, God bless in prayer. Amen? Amen. Have a wonderful evening. God bless you guys. Pastor, God bless you. Amen. Good having you here. Amen. So, happy Father's Day tomorrow, guys. God bless you. Have a beautiful evening. Love you.